Hi there, Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thanks for coming back. I like looking at studies, as some studies are particularly interesting, and often studies tie together a lot of useful information. Many people don't know that studies are conducted on rats and rodents. Now, it's interesting. Often studies, carefully conducted studies, you know, involving rats or rodents, often have a spillover effect when it comes to human studies. There are a lot of correlations there. And oftentimes studies are initially conducted on, you know, on rodents, but then conducted on humans, and they find very, very similar kind of results, you know, similar outcomes. So a study conducted at the Institute of Aging in Baltimore recently found out something very, very interesting with rats. I think it was rats or mice that they used, but they found particular bacteria that we also have in our gut called akkermansia, I think they're called. Now, these are a class of good bacteria. We need these bacteria. They perform many vital roles in our gut. These bacteria are very important because they allow us to break fibers down into short-chain fatty acids. Now, these acids, like butyrate, acetate, valerate, you know, I think there's about six or seven of them. These short-chain fatty acids are very important for intestinal health because they help not just to feed cells up, you know, and provide a very, very healthy ground in the colon, so the colon can again reabsorb what it wants from the stool to keep the body healthy. But these things also create different types of signals where they talk to the immune system. They've discovered that insulin sensitivity is very much affected by these particular bacteria. So when these bacteria go down, insulin resistance develops. Now, this is key because it could push a person into a blood sugar problem and eventually even into diabetes. So even though research is still in the early phases, it looks like potentially there could well be a massive link between gut bacteria and blood sugar responses and diabetes. So I probably won't see it in my lifetime, but eventually I think most chronic diseases will be linked to certain types of bacteria, and eventually they'll work out, they'll be able to do, you know, very careful fingerprinting of a person's microbiome and then make adjustments and corrections and hopefully reverse or counter that chronic disease. It's incredible how we eventually will go from killing and antibiotics to probiotics and building to get people's health up. Medicine and science will finally realize you can't get people's health right by constantly giving toxic chemical preparations that kill cells and cause very strong chemical reactions in the body. You watch what happens. This video will hopefully be up, and I think people will realize it. The only way to confer health and build health is by eating the right kind of foods and getting the right kind of bacteria in the gut to a high spec, and that'll in turn confer amazing health, whether it's emotional health, cognitive health, blood sugar health, endocrine health. It doesn't matter. All health. It should all improve. Thanks for tuning in.